Hey, yo. This one's for you, Professor Staten. Wasn't me. Cat Skull remake.
Incisor, premolar, molar, that cheek. Mandibular, symphysis is where they both meet. Angular process at the bottom's pretty neat. That's all the things I know about the lower jaw, bro. Buck cat, skulls, that other stuff we gotta know. Opener, cranium, holds. Sensory, what does that consist of? Olfactory, what about the optic? It lets you see. What about the otic? Can you hear me?
What the hell is a sinus? A cavity. Well, where can I find one? The nares, where do those lead to? Internally, what can you tell me about them? They're ugly. First we start with the ethmoid region and the nasal capsule spine. Picture this, the median vomer separates the left and right. How could I forget the terminal for the nasal cavity? Or anterior to this is the max and the maxillary. Secondary palate holds all these things. And more posterior, we got the auditory, the tympanic bulla, and the tympanic rings. Tympanal aperture so you can hear us sing. The middle ear ossicles are kinda hard to see. They're inside the mucus, a hole in the bulla. The middle ear ossicles have to hear them beat. Kinda small, might have fallen out of the hola.
Now let's move to the brain case. That's where you see. First we have the frontal. Definitely scooch it back, that's the temporal. Starts with a D. Posterior are the parietal. Starts with a P. Running down the middle. Sagittal crest, but that's one in the back. The nuchal crest, this is the occipital region. Yeah, that's the best. We've covered most of the cat skull. There are abbreviations that we use for teeth. First letters of each tooth make dental formulas. Picture this, the numbers say how many of each kind we have. And the slash, it separates the right side from the left. And man, that's all